Good morning, students, and warm welcome to our BNC Online Education Channel. Myself, Vaishali Ananda Lokhande from Turbe MPS, will be conducting subject science. Today's our topic is very interesting, students. You know why? Because we all interact with that topic now and then. Where we are living, that place is called as Earth. So today we are going to learn something related to Earth, something related to ecosystem, something related to living and non-living organism relationship. So students, let's move on to our topic. So today's our topic name is ecosystem. Now within few seconds, I'll share my screen so that we will move on to our main topic. Yes, students, once again, welcome to our BMC channel. We at BMC have brought education to your doorstep so that our education is not hampered and our studies are not back. So, myself, once again, Vaishali Ananda Lokhande welcomes you to our BMC online channel. Today, we are going to cover the topic ecosystem, biotic and abiotic components, food chain, food web, energy pyramid, and ecological interaction. So students, in this picture, what we are able to see? In this picture, we are able to see that one boy is sitting near the pond and he is enjoying the fishing. So near the pond, around that boy, what all things we can see? We are able to see a few living things and few non-living. So ecosystem is related with living things and non-living things. So all living organisms and non-living organisms constitute of an area together, they form an ecosystem. So dear students, what is meaning of ecosystem? Ecosystem is a combination of living and non-living organisms. Let's move on to the components of ecosystem. There are two components of ecosystem, biotic and abiotic. Abiotic consists of non-living constituents. For example, air, water, wind, soil, temperature, rainfall. Whereas, biotic consists of living organisms. Bio means life. So, biotic components are related to living organisms like plant and trees, human beings, animals. In biotic component of ecosystem, there include three types of organisms: producers, consumers, and decomposers. We are going to see in detail what are producers, consumers, and decomposers in our further slides. Now, first, we are going to classify our ecosystem. Ecosystem is classified into two components, biotic and abiotic. We've seen that biotic means, bio means life. So biotic includes living organisms. Abio means non-living life. So abiotic component includes non-living constituents. In biotic components, there are three categories, producer, consumer, and decomposer. Again, further, consumers are divided into three categories, primary consumer, secondary consumer, and tertiary consumer. Whereas, abiotic component examples we see are air, water, wind, soil, temperature, rainfall. Dear students, we can see that all these examples of abiotic components are non-living. They do not have life. But these components are very important for living organisms. As we know, without air, without oxygen, we cannot live. Without water, we cannot survive. Without wind, we cannot get electricity. We cannot, tidal power is generated. Soil, temperature, rainfall, all these abiotic components are having this or that impact on the living organism. So now, let's move on to in detail about biotic components. See students, in this picture, biotic means life. Don't forget, biotic means life. Biosphere, earth. Biosphere, bio is what? Where the life exists. So earth is called a biosphere, where the life is existing. Here in this picture, we are able to see few plants, sunflower, potato plant, apple tree. Yes? So these plants, any green color plant, are called as producers. Why you know, students? Because plants are capable of preparing their own food with the help of sunlight. They have chloroplasts in them, chlorophyll. With the help of it, they are able to prepare their own food. And the process of preparing their own food is called as photosynthesis. Right, students? So, plants are called as producers. Now, consumer. What is the meaning of consumer? One who consumes, one who takes in food. Right? So, organisms which take food from producers are called as consumer. For example, cow, bear, carnivorous. Consumers are again classified as herbivorous, omnivores, and carnivores. Now, what is the meaning of herbivores? Herbivores are grass-eating animals. Herbivores are grass-eating animals. They directly depend on producers. Omnivores are flesh-eating animals. Carnivores are also flesh-eating animals, right? These indirectly depend on producers, but they directly depend on herbivores. So, consumers are classified as herbivores, omnivores, or carnivores. Now, what are herbivores? Those animals who eat only green plants, they are called as herbivores. Whereas carnivores, they eat other animals. That is, they depend on organisms directly. They are called as carnivores. Now, once again, omnivores, human beings are also classified as omnivores. Why? Because they are both plant-eating also and flesh-eating animals. So, omnivores are... we can give the example for omnivores, human beings, crow, bear, they eat plants also and they eat flesh also. So, once again, consumers are classified into herbivores, carnivores and omnivores. Herbivores are grass-eating animals, carnivores are only flesh-eating animals, whereas omnivores are both plant and flesh-eating animals. Now let's move on to decomposers. Decomposers are microorganisms, small microorganisms, bacteria and fungi. What is the role of these decomposers in our ecosystem, you know, students? What they do? They decomposers. They break down the complex organic substances into simple organic substances. That the meaning of that is when an animal or plant dies, they get buried under the soil. Now, the role of decomposers starts there. What these microorganisms they do, they start decomposing the dead part, dead material of plants and animals, and they convert that in or that matter into organic substances and prepare a good fertilizer for a new producer to grow. So, these microorganisms are called as decomposers. Examples of decomposers are worms, mushrooms, insects, bacteria. They feed on decaying matter. So, decomposers can also be called as microorganisms, which break down the complex organic compounds present in dead animals and plants into simple substances. They make the soil fertile, rich in humus, where a new producer can be grown. So even decomposers has a main role in an ecosystem. These are the decomposers. Once again, example, fungus, beetle, worm. You know, students, decomposers are again classified into two categories, useful and harmful. Useful decomposers, useful microorganisms have benefits the human being, whereas harmful microorganisms, they create effects on the human being. Like, for example, worms, beetles, they are harmful microorganisms. They have adverse effect on human life and also on the ecosystem. Now let's move on to abiotic components. This picture shows you what is the meaning of abiotic factors and also the examples of it. Abiotic factor, as we discussed earlier, they are non-living components of an ecosystem. But these non-living components have a great impact and a great interaction with biotic factors. Examples of biotic factors are wind, sunlight, soil, temperature, atmosphere, water. These all components have a great impact and also an interaction with biotic components in an ecosystem. Now let's move on to food chain and food web present in an ecosystem. Now, what is meaning of food chain? We know, student, on the earth or in an ecosystem, each organism depends on another. For what purpose? For the transfer of food, to get the food, to get the energy. So food chain is related to how an organism gets the energy from another organism. Food chain is a linear sequence. Let's see with example. See, in this picture, we can see that the producer is there, then herbivorous is there, and carnivorous is there. Tree is a producer, deer is a herbivorous, whereas lion is a carnivorous. So, deer depends on tree for its food, for getting energy, whereas lion depends on deer for its food, right? So, this is how the energy is being transferred from tree to deer, from deer to lion. This is called as a food chain. This is called as a food chain. So for example, deer eats leaves are the trees, and the tiger or a lion eats the deer. So this is what a linear food chain, linear sequence. Trees, deer depend on tree, tiger or lion depend on deer. The energy is being transferred from tree to deer, from deer to tiger. This is called as a food chain. This is called as a food chain, and it is a linear food chain. Let's move on to the next picture. This is another example where the energy is being transferred from flower to insect, that is to butterfly, from butterfly to frog, from frog to snake, and from snake to eagle. We know, students, that butterflies sit on flowers. They get honey from the flower. Frog is butterfly. Snake is frog. And eagle is snake. This is how the energy is being transferred from flower to butterfly, from butterflies to frog, from frog to snake, and from snake to eagle. This food chain we can see in the grassland. The flies suck nectar from the flower. Frogs eat the flies, snake eats the flower, whereas eagle is the snake. This is how the energy is being transferred from flower to flies, from flies to frog, from frog to snake, and from snake to eagle. This is again an example of a food chain. Now, what example of food chain we can see in the pond? In the pond, we know there are aquatic plants, aquatic animals, right? Small fishes, big fishes. So, aquatic plants are eaten by small fishes. Small fishes are eaten by larger fishes, whereas these larger fishes are eaten by birds like pelicans present in the water. So everywhere in an ecosystem, let it be a grassland, let it be an aquatic, let it be a terrestrial, aerial, arboreal, any ecosystem, we can see the presence of food chain. Why this food chain is there? In order to get the food and energy transferred from one organism to other organism. Now let's move on to food web. Now what is this food web? Food web is a collection of many food chains connected to each other. It's more realistic interpretation on how food is consumed in an ecosystem. Here, food web is not a linear, it is a network of different food chains. Let's see with an example. See, in this picture, we can see various organisms connected to each other. Eagle. We can see eagle. Now here at the last bottom level, we are able to see the producers. Whereas at this level, we can see the herbivorous. Whereas here we are able to see carnivorous. And at the top, we are able to see the omnivore organism. We will move on to one by one food chain. If we are moving from these producers to rabbit, from rabbit to eagle, this is one food chain. Rabbit eats grass. Rabbit eats grass, whereas eagle eats rabbit. This is a one food chain. If we will move on to the next picture, that is the rat eats grass. Rat is eaten by fox, and fox is again eaten by eagle. This is another example of food chain. But when different food chains get collected, when there is a network of different food chains, it forms a food web. So what is a food web? Food web is a network of different food chains seen in an ecosystem. Let's understand this food web more prescribedly with few examples. In first food chain, we can see that rabbit eats plant and eagle eats the rabbit. This is one linear food chain present in a food web. Next, we can see that rabbit and fox. Rabbit is eaten by fox, whereas fox is eaten by eagle. This is another example where grasshopper eats plant. Grasshopper is eaten by frog. Frog is eaten by snake, and a snake is eaten by eagle. Again, a linear food chain. But the mixture, the network of these different food chains forms a food web. This is another food chain which we can see in that picture. Plant, dragonfly, insect, and eagle. Plant is eaten by dragonfly. Dragonfly is eaten by insect-eating bird, whereas that insect-eating bird is eaten by eagle. And why all these organisms eat one another? To get the energy, to get the food for their existence in the Indian ecosystem. Now let's move on to the next part. That is, these are the different food chains which we can see in a food web. Plant, grasshopper, rat, fox. Again, the fox is rabbit and fox are eaten by eagle. Whereas the other chain we can form is a plant, grasshopper, frog, snake, eagle. So different food chains, it can be observed in the food web. Hope so, students, you are understanding what is the difference between a food chain and a food web. Now let's move on to what is an ecosystem. Till now we have seen that there are abiotic factors present in an ecosystem. Then we studied that what is a food chain, what is a food web, how the organisms interact with each other. So where all these things are happening? These all things are happening in an ecosystem. So ecosystem is made up of biotic as well as abiotic factors. And there is an interaction between living and non-living components of an ecosystem. So let's see how the abiotic factors, that is how the non-living organisms affect in an ecosystem. We have seen that when there a fire destroys the forest, what happens? And in that, the forest community is allowing an organism to thrive. That is, a new or older organisms are died and new organisms can be given birth. Earlier or unexpected frost can kill plants and entire food chain. This is how the abiotic factors are affecting an ecosystem in a living organism. Wind can affect the way an organism grows. See here, in this picture, we can see that how the plant, wind has affected the growth of the plant. It has been, the leaves has been shifted totally towards one side. Whereas in this picture, we can see that the early or unexpected frost, they have killed the plant and they have disturbed the food chain. Here in this picture, we can see that the forest fire has entirely destroyed the forest life. These are what the fire, early wind, then frost, they are the abiotic factors. And mostly these abiotic factors affect the living organism in an adverse condition. Now let's study how the biotic factors, that is the living organisms, affect the abiotic factor in an ecosystem. We know that lichens, right, these are also microorganisms. And they grow on the rock. Rock is what? Abiotic factor. And they break this rock into soil. Lichens are made up of algae and fungi. That means biotic factors have positive impact on the abiotic factor. Here we are able to see a dead organism is dying. It has been dead. Dead organisms and animal waste contribute to the soil nutrients. We know that this, the decomposers, the decay on the organic matter of the dead organism, and they convert these into simpler organic matters, which help to get a good fertile soil where a new nutrient, new plant, a new producer is grown. Now let's move on to different types of ecosystem. There are two types of ecosystem: natural ecosystem and artificial ecosystem. Now let's see what are natural ecosystems. Natural ecosystems are terrestrial ecosystems. Terrestrial means land. Ecosystems related to land. For example, grassland, forest, and desert ecosystem. Whereas aquatic, aquatic meaning is water. Aquatic ecosystems related to water, that is lentic and loctic. Lentic means a stagnant water. Example, lake, pond, etc. Loctic means flowing water, example, river, ocean, sea, etc. So in natural ecosystem, there are two, terrestrial ecosystem and aquatic ecosystem. Now the other part is artificial ecosystem. What is an artificial ecosystem? A cropland, garden, aquarium, park, kitchen garden. They are what? Artificial ecosystems. They are created by human beings. Now we will move on to structural aspects of ecosystem. Now, once again, we will go on to our abiotic, that is a non-living component, and biotic or living component. Now we will come on to the scientific terms, that is, abiotic component consists of inorganic substances, organic compounds, and climatic factors. Whereas living components or biotic component consists of autotrophs or producers, heterotrophs are consumers, and decomposers are saprotrophs. Right, students? So now let's move on to the next part. That is, we are going to see how biotic, that is a living factor, influence on an ecosystem. We can see here in this picture that a biotic component of a grassland have a great impact on the ecosystem. Here, there is, in this picture, we are able to see that how a grassland ecosystem is affected with the help of biotic components. Abiotic non-living factors that affect an ecosystem. We seen in a previous slide that how the unexpected frost, unexpected rain, unexpected high temperature destroys the forest, catches fire. It also affects the growth of the organism. It destroys the whole crop, right? So both biotic and abiotic factors have a great influence on an ecosystem. Now, students, you know what is the main source of energy in an ecosystem? So it is the sunlight. Sunlight is the main source for life on the earth. also called as autotrophs. With the help of sunlight, producers that are green plants are able to prepare their own food. And that process, we all know that, is called as photosynthesis. Now, let's see photosynthesis in details. What happens actually in photosynthesis? Light energy from the sun gets converted into carbon dioxide and water, into oxygen and carbohydrates. What this light energy does? It converts carbon dioxide and water into oxygen and carbohydrate. Oxygen is used by human beings and carbohydrate is used by the plants. Carbohydrate is what? Glucose. The chemical formula of photosynthesis is C6CO2 plus 6H2O gives 6O2 plus C6H12O6. See students, this plant, this leaves is green in color. It takes in sunlight. It takes in carbon dioxide, it takes in water, it undergoes a photosynthesis process and it gives us oxygen and glucose. This is what chemosynthesis, VAC, performed by bacteria. This chemical energy is used to produce carbohydrates. This is how the plant producers prepare their own food. Now let's see how do organisms interact and depend on one another in an ecosystem. We see that in a food chain, why the food chain is required? So, for the transfer of energy and food from producer to consumer, from consumer to decomposer. So food chain is necessary. Right, students? In this picture, we can see that energy is transferred from producer to consumer, from consumer to decomposer. Let's see food chain in detail. So arrow marks will show how the energy is being transferred from grass record to cricket, from cricket to frog, right? From grass to cricket, from cricket to frog, from frog to record. The start is, it is starting with the producer and it ends with the top consumer. So this is how the energy is being transferred from one level to another level, from another level to the next, and then to the top consumer level. Now, how is the feeding interaction? Energy flows through an ecosystem in one direction. We can see that energy is flowing from producer to consumer and not from consumer to producer. So it always remember that energy flows in an ecosystem only in one direction, that is from sun to inorganic compounds, to autotrophs, and then to heterotrophs. But no energy is returned back to the sun. Now, what food web network of a food chain within an ecosystem? This is another example. Right, students? Of a food web, as we have studied earlier, here, first we can move on to the producer, that is grass is eaten by mice is eaten by the weasel, and weasel is eaten by the hawk. Hawk is what? At the topmost consumer level. Another food chain, we can see that grass is eaten by raccoon and raccoon is eaten by the hawk. Here, these are the different food chain, and we get a collection, a network of food chain forms a food web. Now, in an ecosystem, there are different trophic levels. And these trophic levels show how the food chain or how the food is being, energy is being transferred from one level to another. The first level is of producer. Producers means autotroph. Second level is of primary consumer. Third level, secondary consumer. And at the top, it is the tertiary consumer. Producers are always at the first level. Producers are also called as autotroph. Now, let's see how the energy is being transferred, how much of the energy is being transferred from one trophic level to another trophic level. And the producer transfers the energy to the first level, primary consumer. Primary consumers are the herbivores. Secondary consumers are the primary carnivores. And tertiary consumers are the secondary carnivores. So here, the energy is being transferred from producers to primary consumers, from primary consumers to secondary, and from secondary to tertiary consumer. Now, how much of the energy? Let's see. We seen that from producers to primary consumers, from primary consumers to secondary consumers, from secondary consumers to tertiary consumers, the energy is being transferred. That energy, that pyramid is called as energy pyramid. But how much of the energy is being transferred from bottom to the top? That is only 10% of the energy is being transferred. How much? Only 10% of the energy from producer to primary consumers, from primary consumers to secondary, and from secondary to tertiary consumers. Only 10% of the energy is being transferred. So here, this once again, I'll show you the diagrammatic presentation of the energy pyramid that has, it represents the amount of energy available at each level as well as the amount of living tissues. Both decreases with the increasing trophic level. See, dear students, the population is also decreasing. Here, the producer population is more. Here, the producer has the energy, for example, 1000 kilocalories. 1000 kilocalories, right? This energy is being transferred to primary consumers. How much energy is transferred? Only 10%, 100 kilocalories. Population here reduces. Again, from primary consumers, the energy is being transferred to secondary consumers. How much energy is being transferred? Only 10%. That is 10 kilocalories. Population reduces here. Now, this 10 calories from secondary consumers, it is being transferred to tertiary consumers. How much? Only 1 kilocalorie is the energy is being transferred. Again, the population is decreasing. So what we can say, both decrease with the each increasing trophic level. Yes, students, the amount of energy available at each level as well as the amount of living tissues, that is, as the energy is decreasing, the with the increase in the trophic level, population also decreases. Now, how there is an ecological interaction between the organisms in an ecosystem? First, the organisms interact for their competition, for their survival. When two organisms of the same population or of the same species, how they live for their place at the same time, how they manage the crowd for the reason of food, water, and shelter. So they compete with each other. The next is, here in this also, monkeys compete with each other and for other animals for food. Here, rams compete with each other for their mating. Now, the next ecological interaction is niche. In this niche, what happens? Both the organisms live and the roles that an organism has in its habitat. Here, ecological niche of a sunflower. Growing in a backyard includes the observing light, water, nutrients, and it provides shelter to other organisms, for example, bees, ants, and giving of oxygen into the atmosphere. The next interaction is for predation. Predation is where one organism captures and feeds on other organisms. Predator is that one kills, and prey is one that is the food. So here in this picture, we can see that predator, one that does the killing, and prey is what? One that is a food. The next ecological interaction is for symbiosis. Now, what is the symbiosis? Here, any relation in which two species live together, they live closely together, that is mutualism. In this mutualism, both the organisms are benefited. That is, in both the situation, that it is a win-win situation. Insect and flower. Next is communalism. Here, one member is also benefited and other is neither harmed nor helped. Other, here, one example of communalism is bird build nest in the trees. Trees not, is not benefited with anything, but birds get the benefit that they are getting a shelter. Remora fish attaches to the shark and gets a free ride, but shark is neither benefited nor harmed. Now, parasitism, this is a famous ecological interaction we can see mostly in our day-to-day life. One organism lives on another inside organism and it harms it. We can see that the flea is sitting on the dog. What it does, it sucks the blood of the dog. Parasite obtains on all part of its nutritional needs from the host. This is okay, the example of parasitism. Mosquitoes biting human being. Mosquitoes are parasites. They bite us, they suck our blood. Then a sea lamprey feed on fluid of the other fish. So now, this is the chart. This is a slide which will show you how the energy is eventually lost as a heat on the top of the pyramid, but it is neither given back to the sun. We know that only 10% of the energy is being transferred to the next trophic level. 90% of the energy at any given trophic level is used for growth, reproduction, and is eventually lost as heat. Only 10% of the energy is being utilized. Energy flow in a pyramid is a one way. It is neither returned back to the sun. So, dear students, now let's move on to the assessment part. Yes, now I would like to unmute your mic and you have to give me the answer. Yes. First question, dash and dash are the basic components of an ecosystem. Yes. Mute your mic. Very good. See, a very good student. Dash and dash are the basic components of an ecosystem, biotic and abiotic. Very good, excellent. Now, plants are also called dash. Plants are also called ecosystem.
Consumer. Producer.
Yes, mute your mic. Plants are also called producers. Plants prepare their own food. So plants are called as, yes, with the help of sunlight, carbon dioxide and water. Yes, only that energy is being passed to on next topic level in an energy pyramid. How much energy, kitna percent energy pass hota hai? 90% energy is utilized for growth and reproduction. How much energy? Only 10%. 1000 से 100 आया, 100 से 10 आया, right? So how much energy? 10%. Yes. Now, that is the network of different food chain in an ecosystem. क्या बोला जाता है?
Food web.
Very good. Excellent. Food web. Excellent. Now, this one. The microorganism which convert complex organic substances into simple form are called as, क्या बोला जाता है उन microorganisms को? Yes. क्या बोला जाता है? Decomposer. Yes. Now, dear students, it is a time for assignment. Now, you have to define food web, what is food chain, what are parasites, and what is mutualism. We have studied that food web, what is food web, food chain, parasite, and mutualism. Then you have to draw a neat diagram of a food chain of grassland organism. And you have to draw an energy pyramid showing only 10% of energy is being passed on to the next trophic level. Yes, students, understood your homework? What you have to do? You have to define what is food chain, what is food web, then parasite and mutualism. You have to write the definition of these four and then you have to draw the two diagrams. In first diagram, you are going to draw a food chain of a grassland organism, whereas In the second diagram, you have to draw an energy pyramid. It's showing only 10% of energy is being transferred, is being passed on to the next trophic level. Understood, students? Today's homework. And the next is you have to write a note on biotic component with example. And also, you have to explain what are abiotic factors of an ecosystem. So, without fail, if you like my today's lecture, you have to like, comment, share and subscribe. And once again, thank you for watching.